She'll put on my things, I shall. Oh, wait. Destination Yuri, you're welcome. If you're just joining us, thank you for being with us. If you've been here from the beginning, 0730 hours Irish time, 5 days a week. Two good people with me at the moment. The lady Orla Jackson of Newry Chamber of Trade and Commerce. The gentleman, Paddy Malone from the Dundalk Chamber of Trade and Commerce. That's broadly got that right. And it's I have this notion that you that there is something happening. There's a symbiotic thing occurring where Newry South continues to reach out towards Dundalk and Dundalk North continues to reach out, that there's going to be a time within the next decade that there'll be a coming together and we'll have a new city, Dunure or something like that. Is it a madness or is it even remotely possible?
You never know. You never know what the future may bring. But the Newry Chamber and the Dundalk Chamber of Commerce, we have a very close working relationship with each other. And we've, over the past number of years, we've hosted quite a number of networking events for our members. Yes. And they've been very, very positive. And the two organisations working together, you know, they're able to provide excellent services for the local business
community. Are there areas, Paddy, where they get on your wick, the these northerners? Or is it all sweetness and light?
It's like any marriage that doesn't run smoothly completely the whole time, you know? But there's a recognition, I think, both in Newry and Dundalk, that if we're going to counterweight that huge balance of Belfast and Dublin,
yeah,
and not be sucked in as dormitory towns of either,
yeah,
we have to create a cluster of our own that's strong enough to bat on our own bat.
Cluster is a nice word, isn't it?
It is.
I love that word.
Yeah, there was a report done a couple of years ago. The ICLRD made a report calling for the twin city approach of Newry and Dundalk.
Yes.
Now, Dundalk wouldn't claim to be a city, so we'll bow to Newry's status on that score.
Newry wasn't much good at building Henkel bubble cars and things like that. We were.
We built the Henkel. For those of you who don't know what he's talking about, we built a three-wheel car that opened at the front, one single door. They were made out of German bomber engines that had been bought by some entrepreneur in Dundalk, from Dundalk, who went to Germany and bought them after the Second World War. Nobody else wanted them. Yep. And we turned them into cars. And we still get British people, particularly in the English people, there's a group around the Midlands who actually come over every year to have a look at the Henkel.
And the one Henkel is
there. One Henkel in the museum. In the museum. Yeah.
But of course, you've got the great Arctic explorer there as well, from Sailortown and Dundalk. Oh, what was his name? The fellow who went to... there you are. It's gone from me. That's what happens when you're 70.
You have me stumped on that one.
He was very, very... I did a nationwide program on it. And he went to discover the lost expedition that had gone out to find the Northwest Passage. And he was a Dundalk man.
Well, you learn something new every day. Thank you for that.
There you are.
The next time I'm here, I'll have the answer for you.
I love the answer too. It's annoying when you can't remember these things. You have a conference coming up, Orla.
Yes, we've got a cross-border business support expo. The objective behind it is to provide a facility for all local businesses in the Newry Dundalk region to meet with the wide breadth of business support agencies out there in one morning under one roof, to find out information that will help and assist their businesses. So if any businesses have questions to ask about where they should seek finance, if they're looking to expand, what information and advice is out there, if they're looking support by way of grants, they'll be able to find out information from those that are able to give grants. Yeah. So there's going to be over 33 exhibitors confirmed for the event, and that would include the big names such as the Invest NI, the Enterprise Ireland, Newry and Warren District Council, Louth County Council, InterTrade Ireland, Eures. A very wide breadth of all the business support agencies that therefore are catering for this area will be in the world.
I confess to you, I have reached those happy, lazy, hazy days of autumn where I don't have to worry about money anymore. I can, if push comes to shove, I can live on my two modest pensions, so I don't have to tax my brain at being entrepreneurial. But I mean, there are people out there who are building, young people, people with experience who are doing things. It's happening in both towns, Paddy.
Yeah, and I think the thing about the internet and being able to go onto Google or and do a search on the organisations that we will have there, that's one thing. But there's nothing like face-to-face contact and actually asking somebody else on the far side of a desk. And what I find very often when people come to me, I'm an accountant, and they actually don't know the question to ask, or they're only hazy, and it's only when you tease it out with them. And that's where one-to-one talking, and just talking it through. And the other thing to remember is, we will have people there who are starting a business, maybe thinking of going from Dundalk into Newry, or Newry into Dundalk, or other things. There could be complementary businesses. There could be businesses there, and that's something the Chamber would be anxious to encourage all the year round. Yeah. That if somebody is interested in going from Dundalk, going into Newry, or Newry into Dundalk, well, why not use the Chamber as your first port of call?
Absolutely.
Find out what's life on the other side of the border.
Yeah.
We have so many similarities, but there are differences.
That's what I was going to say.
And they can mess you up if you don't. If you know about them in advance, you have no problem.
Yeah.
But you need to plan.
That's what I was thinking. What's the adage? It's a bit, if you failing to plan is planning to fail. I understand that concept, but is it the case, and you alluded to it there, that the native relevant legislation in each area could make any togetherness difficult?
That's one of the things that we've been tackling with in the Chambers over the last couple of years. We've been on delegations to Belfast and to the Dáil in Dublin, and we've been talking to European minister, European MEPs about this, about trying to make this region work as a unit, you know, not from a political point of view, but from an economic point of view, so that everyone will win, whether it's Newry or Dundalk. Now, you know, Dundalk in the south is one of 8 gateway towns designated for rapid growth.
Yeah.
It's why we got PayPal and eBay.
Yeah.
It's why we, you know, we got 10% of all investment in the south, foreign investment south, last year. We got 10% of the
Dundalk
entire lot. Dundalk, not Louth.
Yeah,
Dundalk got it.
Yeah.
No, it was catch up.
Yeah.
Because parts of Dundalk have got huge deprivation problems.
Mm.
But we will catch up. But we have the DKIT, and I know the DKIT is anxious to work with the Southern Regional Health Board in Newry.
Yeah.
And we need to realise that we have complementary assets, and we need to work together.
Would be very keen on that, wouldn't he? Brian Doran in the Southern Regional College. They're an excellent institution there. And your DKIT is the same. They're impressive.
Yes.
They cater for so many students, and it's good to provide alternative options for students who can study degree and postgrad qualifications here in either Newry or at Dundalk, you know, rather than having the expenses of living away maybe across in England or wherever.
The other thing to say is this conference may well be of assistance in helping people recognise for a start the questions that they need to ask.
Correct.
In opening another door of opportunity, a door that is a business opportunity in the Dundalk, Republic of Ireland area that they mightn't have thought about up to now.
Absolutely. It's all about opening up people's minds, our event next week. It's free of charge, and it's like a drop-in centre, so basically anybody can call
in.
It's Carrickdale Hotel on the 30th of January from 9:30 in the morning to 1 p.m. So you can drop in at any stage and speak to anybody. You might go over and want to speak to Invest NI. They may say, listen, if you're interested in doing work as a Northern company in Dundalk, why don't you speak to Intertrade Ireland as well? Why don't you also speak to Enterprise Ireland? Why don't you, you know, go and speak to the other different agencies out there? So there's going to be a lot of signposting for the local businesses as well. And it's up to the businesses to come with an open mind to the event. And also, you know, have their questions prepped in their head. You know, what are they looking to get out of the event? What information are they hoping to secure and achieve? And you know, we would advise the businesses that do attend on the event, make sure you follow up on the information that you receive.
Follow up, Paddy, is hugely important.
Yeah, funnily enough, we had a different session last night. We were talking about that very point, that sometimes the follow-up isn't as strong as it should be. Mm-hmm. And in fact, when we were marking out what we were going to be talking about next week, it was to emphasize that very point. That was the one that came out over and over again from people follow-up. Who had participated in previous ones. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But, you know, just to back up what Otto was saying, if any business in Newry has got capacity now at this stage to grow the business and they find that they've reached the market in Newry or in Belfast, Dundalk,
it's only 20 minutes down the road now, and less than 20 minutes in the new motorway job.
And you don't even realise you've crossed the border anymore.
Yeah. How you're pivotally placed to observe on this, but I mean, what way is the economy in Dundalk at the moment? Are people
flat. Now, at least it's not getting any worse, if you pardon me by bad English. But if it's not getting any worse...
I have to say, you use bad English beautifully.
Thank you very much.
It's just the way you did it there. You did it with panache and aplomb.
It's no worse than it was, but there is a certain level of confidence beginning to creep in.
Yes.
And it was interesting, we had a public meeting there in December, and we were asking businesses for feedback. And it was the first time that I would say that the majority were positive.
Mm.
Now, it was mostly that they were positive, it wasn't getting any worse.
Mm.
But there was a positivity there. They might be investing later in this year. So I'm hopeful that we will start to see a recovery.
So that's good. That's the kind of message that Fergal's bringing us here every Tuesday. Fergal McCormack is our fiscal guru, if you like. He's been talking for the last 6 months of slowly, 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 slowly peeping above the rim of the difficulties we're going through.
Yeah. What we need to get out is the old Roosevelt statement, there's nothing to fear except fear itself.
Yeah.
There are people with money.
Mm.
And we really need to encourage them to go out and invest. Now, not speculatively like happened before, but to invest in a controlled and planned way. And that will create growth, and that generates further growth. You know, and it's, you know, the likes of the PayPal and the eBay coming into us, that created a huge buzz around the area, because suddenly people realised we have the telecommunications in the area that works. I mean, you have your own internet connection companies here in Newry.
First Derivatives is a huge
success story, you know. And it just goes to show that we can complement each other. We you know, and I know that, for example... The Polish consulate in Northern Ireland.
Our own
good friend, Jerome.
Absolutely.
A friend of both chambers, well, a member of your chamber, but a friend of mine for over 10 years. One of the things we did for one of the things that he rang me and he said, can you get me into PayPal?
Wow.
So I said, yeah. So he went to, the reason being, PayPal are looking for Eastern European speakers.
Yes.
They're looking for Poles, they're looking for Russians.
Yes.
So, you know, I was only too delighted to put...
Of course,
so if job people from Newry, Polish people, or anybody, any other language are coming into Dundalk, that's great.
Yeah. You used one word there that I found, that I picked up on, can. We can cooperate.
Yes.
That would indicate it's not happening.
Oh, no, it is happening. No, I think we worked on a report 4 years ago now at this stage, the McArdle report, which highlighted the chronic need for closer cooperation between the two areas and the fact that governments needed to respond more vigorously. Now, I think both of us would be disappointed with the response. I think Dublin looks south and I think Belfast looks towards Derry, with all due respect to the rest. And I think this area needs... but we are strong in our collaboration between the two.
Yeah.
We don't have a problem.
So you're the cluster?
We are the cluster. We see ourselves as the counterweight to that growth of Belfast and Dublin. Mm-hmm. Because Drogheda has been lost, with all due respects to that town.
Yeah,
it has become a dormitory town of Dublin.
It has.
And we do not want the same thing happening to ourselves.
No.
We have a proud tradition of engineering and brewing, and including the Heinkel. But we have that proud tradition. We don't want to be a dormitory town.
No.
And we see our best chance is to swim with Newry.
And vice versa. Obviously, announcements such as PayPal has a positive impact on Newry. You know, as Paddy pointed out, there will be Newry people employed in corporations.
Right.
So, you know, we see, you know, a rising tide carries
and
all boats.
It does, and we can see your lot coming up to Newry. Mm-hmm. Like, look down at the quays there, the jobs that are in the teleperformance. That's for people of a certain technical expertise, a certain easement with computer technology and all the rest of it. That teleperformance thing is a huge job for folk to have, and your folk coming to us, Scott, here. Of course, the bridge would have made a difference. You're the first Southerner I've had sitting there to ask about the bridge. How did the council in the South mess up on the bridge?
I don't know, but there's a few people, I'm not going to mention them personally, but there's a few people that I'm very disappointed with that they got the figures so bloody wrong.
How do they get... I was once a quantity surveyor a long, long time ago. And it's very simple. The architect does the plan. I get the plan. I take off the plan and I make the bill of quantities. I then cost the bill of quantities. It's not magic.
Well, as an accountant, I can tell you it hasn't always happened that the QS has got the job right.
Yeah, but to 70 million out.
But to be 100% out is extremely embarrassing.
It is.
County Council, the County Manager, Con Murray, at the time, put a huge amount of his personal reputation on getting this built. I led a delegation up to see Varadkar, and to be honest with you, I went to meet him to talk about the project. And he was there with his road advisors. Now, he's Minister for Transport and Tourism.
Yes.
And I had to say to his transport managers, with all due respects, if this was a transport project, I wouldn't be here. Yes. So, Minister, will you get rid of these two and bring in your tourism guys?
Yeah.
And I knew one of the transport guys. Yeah. He was a friend of mine. And I said, you're the wrong person here. Yeah. Minister, we are talking about a tourism project. We are not talking about transport.
Yeah.
Transport, it barely passed the line. It did qualify, but barely. It was a tourism potential for the region.
Absolutely.
Because there's one thing that we've thought about a lot is Cooley is a beautiful region. The Mourne's are superb. Gullion is good. The Mourne's is the crowning of those three. The Mourne's is the crown. But by itself, it's not got the pull that
the disembodied.
It's not got the weight of Kerry or the weight of elsewhere. But the three combined do.
Yeah.
You know, and we've got to get that message across. Tourism is the 21st century's industry. Computers was the last century. We have it built here. We have 2.5 million people within striking distance of the Mourne and the Cooley region. There's nowhere else in the island that has that reach.
That's true. And Orla, we're not giving up. It was interesting to see within the recent past that Simon Hamilton has given qualified support to the bridge. He's a wee bit late, but...
it's not so hard to give support after
after
a decision has
so
been
crazy.
Made, you know.
Yeah.
But we have, we're in the fortunate position in that Minister Hamilton is coming to a Chamber Business Lunch on Wednesday. So we'll be talking to him about infrastructure in the area and pressing him on the much need for greater investment in infrastructure, especially now that the bridge is you know, it's not being supported.
Yes.
So we'll be pressing the case very, very hard for a Southern Relief Road in particular, which would once again tick all the boxes, including the tourism, including
It must sicken both your happinesses to hear Danny in Belfast yesterday talking about putting 11 million into the bridge across the Lagan from the gasworks site to Ormer Park.
Well, the thing about the bridge that we were talking about was it was mostly going to be funded from European funding, that if it wasn't spent here, wasn't going anywhere on the island.
That's right.
You know, so, I mean, while I'm all in favour of whether it's European money or whether it's British taxpayers or whether it's Irish taxpayers, of it being used properly, as an accountant, I abhor waste. It was a glorious opportunity to get that right.
It was. But as Orla says, we're not giving up.
No,
looking good.
But I mean, if the South can, if we can do anything, if it's dead, then the Southern Relief Road. I never saw them competing with each other. I knew some people from the very beginning.
Yeah.
But we would understand the need for the Southern Relief Road, and we would be completely in favour of working with and doing anything we can to help on that.
Of course you would. Well, the big thing then is the Carrickdale Hotel.
Absolutely.
We'll remind people again about that.
It's open for all businesses, whether you're a new start business, whether you're an expanding business, whether you're a business that's needing a little bit of assistance. It's open to all businesses from 9:30 in the morning through to 1 o'clock. Come and speak to the advisors.
And I would also say that if for those that are unemployed or maybe know that it's about to happen, why not just have a chat?
Shoot the breeze.
I mean,
come along and
no harm. There's no commitment. you're not going to be asked for your name and your passport number and everything else. No. You're just, it's an informal, friendly chat, and you can ask the stupid questions.
Yeah. And if you are down, if you are unemployed, who has it said, you might be in the gutter,
but you can still see the stars. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's what it's about, seeing the stars, isn't
it?
Really?
Absolutely. Yeah. And there will be the support agencies there, such as DEL and the equivalent in the Republic of Ireland, the Employment and Learning. So they will be able to provide advice, with regard to looking for a new job.
And not losing benefits when doing so. That's important. Mm-hmm. Because, your first responsibility is to your family.
Absolutely.
You don't want to do that. But there are a lot of people who are out of fear of losing benefits.
Mm. Keep the head down.
Keep the head
down.
Either work in the black economy or keep the head down. Yeah. And really, the message is that the situation of black and white is no longer there. Mm. There are shades of grey that the departments are now a bit more flexible in recognising. Yeah.
These are lovely messages you guys are giving out.
Thank you.
I'll almost pull myself back from my autumnal grazing.
Well, we're here to support the local business communities, if anybody out there has any queries or questions, feel free to pick up the phone, contact myself, Patty, or Brenda in the Dundalk Chamber offices. We're just there to point you in the right direction and give you a wee bit of support.
I lost a good Dundalk friend recently. You may have known him. Patter Byrne.
Didn't know.
Patter built the... He built hearses in Dundalk.
All right.
Byrne Coach Building. He was a great sailing man.
Oh, okay.
Man of great happiness. We lost him. He did. He died after a long fight, a long struggle.
Well, the hearse building and that whole region, that all came out of the old Great Northern Railway.
Yes, of course.
I mean, there were two great railway centres in Ireland, the Great Southern, based in Inchicore in Dublin, and the Great Northern, which was not based in Belfast, like everybody would half expect. Mm-hmm. It was based in Dundalk, and the engineering tradition we had, huge. We still have a wee bit of it. Mm-hmm. We have a company called Moffat. If you ever drive behind a big 40-foot truck and you see this little...
The Moffat Mountie.
Dangling behind
built
it, built in Dundalk.
In Dundalk, by Jim McAdam.
That's correct.
His crowd, yes indeed, goodness gracious. So you're all neighbours' children, as they say.
Jim McAdam and myself were lifeguards together in the old Blackrock pool.
Were you? For goodness sake. And Monley's there too, living round the corner.
That's right.
God bless you. You're good people. Thank you very much for coming in.
Much appreciated.
Don't lose us. You know, if you think of us as a hinterland, you come in here, this studio is yours, as much as it's yours.
Well, Margaret, thank
you. You're welcome any time. So once again, the conference coming on the 30th, in the Carrickdale Hotel, all day long.
9:30 to 1 p.m.
9:30 to 1 p.m. Get up there, find out about it, and make it your own. I think that's the best we can ask people. McClintock is the man's name.
Oh,
the explorer. From Seatown.
Okay.
And he went out to discover what happened, the expedition that went to find the Northwest Passage. And he invented a very special... In the spirit of the Henkel, a very special ski for going across the tundra.
Well, you learn something new every day. Thank you very much
Dundalk.
For that.
Yes. you probably know my other colleague in Dundalk, Michael Ryan. He was in insurance.
Yes, of course, yes.
Michael, he's a good lad. Right, that's enough nonsense about Dundalk and Yuri and me and all the rest of it. Thank you for coming in. Go well, take care. Andrew, maestro music, please.